Hey everyone, it's Justin again. Today, we're going to use trigonometric ratios and similar triangles. Let's get started. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to use similar triangles and trig ratios to find missing side lengths. First, we'll compare similar triangles to see that they have the same trig ratios. Next, we'll use our calculators to check our answers. Finally, we'll complete a practice problem. Before we get started today, let's get a refresher on similar triangles. In similar triangles, corresponding angles are congruent and corresponding sides are proportional. For example, these two triangles have the same angle measurements, and the corresponding sides in the second triangle are twice as long as those in the first triangle. These are similar triangles. Let's begin by finding the sine of this 30 degree angle. Since sine is the ratio of the opposite side over the hypotenuse, we get 1 over 2. That looks great, but let's look at a triangle twice as big. It's similar to our original triangle. Pause the video now and find the sine of this 30 degree angle. For this larger triangle, we get 2 over 4. Now what about another similar triangle with side lengths of 3 times the original? This ratio is 3 over 6. You may notice something about all of these fractions. They simplify to be 1 over 2. Anytime we calculate the sine of a 30 degree angle, we get 1 over 2. Using what we just learned, can you find the value of x? Pause the video and try this on your own. We know from earlier in this video that our fraction has to simplify to 1/2, so we can multiply both sides by 9 and say that x is 4.5. It's great to use a pattern like this, and it can be very helpful, but what if the numbers aren't so nice, or we don't have another triangle to compare it to? Well, then let's learn how to solve for x on our calculators. Let's look at the same equation and pretend we don't already know the answer is 4.5. We can multiply both sides of this equation by 9. Now that x has been isolated, we could type 9 times the sine of 30 into our calculator. We do not need to type in the degree symbol. Pause the video now and use your calculator to find 9 times the sine of 30. Did you get 4.5? If not, that's fine. I have some calculator tips to show you. The first tip is to make sure your calculator is in degree mode rather than radian mode. Radians are another way to measure angles that we won't be using until pre-calculus. Second, don't type in the degree symbol. Third, some calculators allow you to type in 9 times the sine of 30 just as you see it here, while other calculators want you to type 30, then hit the sine button, and then multiply it by 9. Time for one more example. Use trig ratios in similar triangles to solve for x, then verify your solution on your calculator. So, basically, let's try this problem both ways, and we'll see that our answers come out to the same thing no matter which way we do it. The first way is to set up trig ratios for each triangle and compare them. Pause the video now, try this out for yourself. Let's see if your trig ratios are correct. First, we are using cosine this time since we have the adjacent side and the hypotenuse. For both triangles, the cosine of 36.9 degrees should simplify to be the same ratio. For the first triangle, we get 4 over 5. For the second triangle, we get x over 10, which should simplify to equal 4 over 5. This means x should be 8. We can even see that the sides of the second triangle are twice as long. Let's try that same problem using an algebraic expression on our calculator. For the second method, pretend you don't have this triangle here to refer to. Can you still get 8 as a solution? Pause the video now and set up an equation. Then type that expression for x into your calculator. Check that your equation is set up correctly. Then we multiply both sides by 10. Type the expression 10 times the cosine of 36.9 into the calculator and get 8. Also note that if you didn't get exactly 8, but That's because 36.9 was rounded a little bit too. Now you can use right triangle trigonometry. We learned that similar triangles have the same trig ratios and how to solve for an unknown in a trig ratio using a calculator. Now we're ready to see how trig ratios can be used in the real world. See you next time. Hey.